We have seen all the values of APC, APS, MPC and MPS. Now we'll see the determinants of investment. We have seen autonomous investment and induced investment and how to draw those curves. Now we'll see determinants of investment. So determinants of investment. So here there are two factors on which the determinants of investment depend. So the first factor is marginal efficiency of investment. So when you say marginal efficiency of investment, it is supply price and prospective yield. So what is marginal efficiency of investment? How much you are paying for the investment and the return of investment. So you compare and find out the marginal efficiency of investment. Supply price is the price of machinery you pay for making investment. So you are buying a machinery for 10,000 rupees. So that is the machinery, may be the replacement or buying a new machinery. So that is the supply price. That is the supply price for investment. Then prospective yield. So how much you are getting it, the return from the investment. So when you get the return from the investment, you compare with the supply price. How do you compare? The prospective yield divided by investment. For example, your supply price is 10,000 rupees and out of 10,000 rupees you are getting 1,200 rupees as a return that from the machinery or from the production. Then you have to spend around 200 rupees for maintenance or repair work something. Then you get 1,200 minus 200, 1,000 rupees the returns. So that 1,000 rupees return for rupees 10,000, which is your supply price. So that is the marginal efficiency of investment. So 1,000 divided by 10,000. That is the marginal efficiency of investment. Now the next factor is rate of interest. So what do you do when you take a loan or when you borrow? Then you compare the marginal efficiency of investment and the rate of interest. So if marginal efficiency of investment is more than rate of interest, then your investment is profitable. So you analyze that, then what do you do? You carry on your investment or you carry on production till MEI is equal to that both of them become equal, till MEI is equal to RI. Marginal efficiency of investment equals to rate of interest, the production will be going on. So this is the determinant of investment. Then other aspects of investment, you find ex ante saving and ex ante investment. So ex ante is planned. Planned saving, and that is you would like to save, you are intended to save, then you are voluntarily that is done and you are the desire to save. So that is what meant by ex ante. So ex ante saving and ex ante investment, but this is not actual, you are planning to do that. The next you find ex post saving and ex post investment. So exposed saving is what has taken place, though the actual saving than actual investment. So in an economy, equilibrium is determined when planned saving is equal to the planned investment. So these concepts are equal only at equilibrium level of income. And when does it happen? Saving is done by households and is investment investment is done by the firms. So they are two different people. Saving is made in small amount, whereas investment is made in big amount. Saving is for meeting expenses, sudden expenses in the future, and investment is made for profit motive. So they are equal only at the equilibrium level. So X, Y, and T variables form the basis of theory of national income determination. When X ante saving is not equal to X ante investment, the output, this is what you should know, the output will be adjusted till they become equal. This is an important aspect of it. That's why you are learning about this variable. The exposed or actual saving is a sum of total of planned saving and unplanned saving. Then exposed investment, again the sum of actual investment in an economy to during a year. So the exposed or actual investment is the sum total of planned and unplanned, because it has happened. You would have, people would not have planned to invest, or people would not have planned to save, but they did. So this is what a sum of planned and unplanned. So X ante you are planning, you desire to do that, you are intended to do that. So the planned value of variables are their X ante measures, whereas realized value of variables are their exposed measures. This is the main difference between these two.